All right, so let us move on to conclusion. Okay, so magnetic poles exist in pairs, they cannot be monopole. Every molecule of a magnet is a complete magnet by itself. What does this mean? Do you guys know what a molecule is?
Ma'am, molecules make elements.
Molecules make elements. No, it is the other way around. Elements make molecules. But what are molecules? So atoms are the smallest unit of matter. Okay, so matter is anything, everything. Okay, so this is matter. I am matter, you are matter, this pen is matter, everything that you see around you is matter. And atoms are the smallest building blocks of those matters. Okay, so these smallest building blocks of matter are called atoms. When you put atoms together, they form molecules. So just like when you put cells of living organisms, when you put cells together, they form tissues. Tissues you put together, they form organs. Organs you put together, they form a body. Right? Just like that, you put atoms together, they form molecules. You put molecules together, they form a mass, they form matter. Okay?
And so, actually, when you when a collection of organs are like systems, like digestive system, respiratory system, and circulatory system.
So overall attractive power of a magnet is equal to the sum total of attractive powers of molecular magnets. So what this means is, let's say I have a magnet and I break this magnet into two parts, part one and part two. Okay. So if this magnet had some magnetic power, okay, let's say it had some magnetic power. Then what is, let's say the magnetic power of this original magnet was 100. Okay. Now I break this into two parts. One is 30 and the other is 70. Now, what will be the total of these two parts, the magnetic power of these two parts?
Ma'am, are you asking all together?
No, just the smaller two parts.
Smaller two parts, one is 30 and the other one is 70.
Yes, so what is the total?
100.
100, which is equal to the original part, yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now what happens if I divide this magnet into more than two parts? So let's say I divide this magnet into five parts, okay? So I divide this magnet to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I divide it into five equal parts, okay? So these five are all equal parts. So how much will be the power of each magnet?
20, ma'am.
20, excellent. Yes, 100 by 5. Good, Pragya. All right, so what this means is, now if I break this piece of magnet, I broke it into five parts. What if I break this magnet into millions of parts? Okay, millions of parts. So if I break this into like tiny, 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 tiny parts, so many parts that each part becomes equal to a molecule. So if I break this into millions of molecules, then I have the sum total of all of these millions of molecules will be equal to the magnetic power of the original molecule. That is what this is saying. So the attractive power of a magnet is equal to the sum total of the attractive powers of molecular magnet. So all of the molecules present within that magnet, if I sum total all of their powers, then it becomes equal to the power of the original magnet. Okay, so in this animation on the right hand side, it says the Earth's iron core. So do you all know that the Earth has a very hot iron core right inside the center of it?
Yeah. Are you telling about the axis?
No, I'm talking about the core of the Earth. What is the Earth made
of?
Yes,
ma'am. There's like a ball full of heat.
Exactly. So inside the Earth, there's like a ball full of heat. It is a semi-solid core, but it is all made up of iron. Okay, so yes, nickel as well. So this huge ball of iron inside the Earth's at the center of the earth is magnetic in material, because it, at the end of the day, it is an it's a ball of iron, right? So because it's magnetic in material, it should have its own poles. So that is why the Earth is basically a huge magnet. And you can imagine it as a magnet that looks like this, that keeps on spinning on its axis, okay? So this magnet, there will be a North Pole and there will be a South Pole, all right? So that is
not clear. Can you please tell me about the Earth you are talking about?
Yeah, so this is the Earth's core. Core means the center, okay? The meaning of core means center. You can see this red ball of fire, right?
Yeah, ma'am.
So that red ball of fire is nothing but really, really hot iron, okay? So that hot iron, at the end of the day, it is still iron, right? And we know that iron is magnetic, is a magnetic material. So and it also has nickel, okay? So these, so it, ma'am, how do we figure out which side is north and which side is south? I will tell you that, Pragya, hold on, just give me a moment, okay? So so what I was saying is I have this magnet right at the center of the earth, okay? Now this magnet, you can imagine it as so let's say I have this magnet over here. Imagine this is the core of the earth, and this core will also have a north and south. Let's say this is the north and this is the south. I can write this as, it is similar to imagining a bar magnet which has a north and south. I can imagine it like that, yes?
Yeah,
that is what this image is showing. This image is showing that this core can be imagined as a bar magnet which has a north and a south. Okay, so guys, how do we tell what is north and what is south? Any idea? So I want you guys, so this is your homework. I want you guys to think about it. Think about all the things that
I think I got the answer.
Yes, Vamika, go ahead. What is the answer?
So when we suspend it freely, as it is said that it always points in the north-south direction. So when we suspend it, so the part in the front is considered as the north and the part at the back is considered at the south. So like that, we can get to know.
Okay, so here's the thing. Your answer is partially correct, but not fully correct, okay? But you are getting there. You have the right idea. You're heading in the right direction.